Welcome to Feed Dump 99. I'm Graham, and joining me this week is the long-awaited combination of Kathleen.
Long-awaited by us, but maybe not you.
And James.
I'm not even supposed to be here today.
And let's get right to the news. When police and game officials were trying to hunt down a rogue moose in Vermont, it led them to a marijuana grow-op.
Yeah, that's cool.
Isn't that what mooses are supposed to do?
You guys are supposed to be funny. Get it together.
But Graham, you don't understand. James and I were trying to do like a postmodern commentary on expectations versus results, and by asking us to be funny, you've ruined it.
Also, I said mooses, which sounds kind of funny to me.
Hey man, I'm a stone moose.
James, those are reindeer antlers.
Just go with me on this. It's all we have. 420 and stuff, I guess.
A biochemistry professor from the University of Saskatchewan is theorizing that there could be health benefits to picking your nose and eating it.
And he can theorize that as long as he wants, because I am not testing it.
Sorry, what was that? I wasn't listening.
His theory is that by consuming the pathogens caught within the mucus, we could be teaching our immune system more about the diseases that could surround us.
Whoa, it's not like this shit has had no interaction with us whatsoever. It was inside my nose! My immune system's gotten a taste of it, and it's like, no, get rid of it! Put it in mucus and get it out!
The left side tastes sweeter than the right.
I thought me and Matt had to talk to you about why you shouldn't be snorting powdered sugar up your nose.
And I ignored you.
I feel this is an appropriate time to cut away to the worst episode of Intervention ever.
It's the worst episode of intervention ever.
James, we found the dozen cake donuts.
So?
They used to be powdered, didn't they?
You can't prove anything.
Yeah, that was a terrible episode of Intervention. I don't think you solved his problem at all.
Hey, look, it's not my problem. His problem is being disgusting.
It's not my problem you find it disgusting. Hey, Graham, is there anything in there about sharing snot? Because I'd be willing to try yours if you want to try mine.
No.
You may have a real problem with other people's snot, Kathleen. This might be time for another worst episode of Intervention ever.
It's the worst episode of intervention ever.
I think you have a problem.
I legitimately do have a problem, yeah.
Look, here. I'll try it. It's really not that bad.
No.
It's okay.
No.
You just need to face your fears. It's okay.
A California woman is facing attempted murder charges after trying to sneak into a Starbucks and replace bottles of orange juice with bottles laced with lethal doses of rubbing alcohol.
Holy shit. Okay, like, I have a whole spectrum of CRAY that I classify feed dump stories as, but it usually just goes from, girl, slow down, people gonna think you CRAY, to, bitch be trippin', but like, I have had to extend the spectrum for this woman, right to, whoa, bitch!
And really, hasn't OJ killed enough people?
Too soon!
No, it's not.
So police haven't figured out a motive yet, but I'm guessing maybe they just messed up her drink?
On the CRAY scale, that registers as, girl, whoa.
Or perhaps she's a fan of rival chain Coffee Bean and Tea Leaf.
If that's the case, that bumps her all the way up to, lady, whoa, 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 on the CRAY scale.
Or, and this one's kind of weird, the Starbucks mermaid in the logo came to her in a dream and told her to do it.
For those of you playing the home game, that puts you at the very far end of the CRAY scale, otherwise known as BITCH NO!
Prison inmates in the US have found a new outlet to express displeasure of their living conditions. They're going on Yelp.
South Carolina State Penitentiary. Unfriendly guards. Boring, uninspired food menu. C-, would not commit a felony to enter again.
Man, if everybody in prison has comfy coats and iPads, sign me up!
In addition, facility provides poorly fitting clothes, and iPad smart case cover clashes terribly. Seriously? Red and orange? What were they thinking?
Alright, so you're telling me that these guys presumably get a finite amount of time online, and they choose to spend it writing reviews on Yelp that will have no effect on anything whatsoever.
Some of the prisons aren't even doing that badly. One of them, the cons, lots of people, way overcrowded, death row has something like 600 people, the stench is horrendous, especially in the mess hall. Pros, cool location, air conditioning not necessary, great view if you can get it, has a hospital, industries to make office furniture, offers a prison university, nice gardening in the courtyard, and a few other nooks. This sounds like a bed and breakfast I wouldn't mind staying at if there was a few less people.
I don't know about you, but I would also prefer that my B&B did not come with a death row.
Although, depending on the rates, not really a deal breaker.
After this, I might start looking for good places to commit crimes. Until next time, remember, there may be better sources for news, but they don't have this hat. I don't know where it's from, but I like it.
Like, I'm feeling sick just thinking about that. Sorry. And she should probably get this on film, but I'm literally this disgusted.
I'm rolling.
Oh, good. I'll put this as an outtake.